tech fluff. So yes, this is, I'm Paul Carr. This is the launch of The Upgrade, which is my book about living in hotels. But there's also a lot of stuff about technology in here, including how I ended up getting fired from The Guardian and The Telegraph and almost TechCrunch a few times. There's a whole story about how I met Mike Arrington in here, how I met Sarah Lacey. It's basically a tech book. I don't know why I'm fucking pretending it's travel.
So would you say to tech people you're living the dream?
Would say to tech people I'm living the dream.
Really?
That's what I'd say. If I were to be confronted suddenly by tech people, I would say, hello tech people, I'm living the dream. Yeah, I would say certainly that thanks to the internet and technology, I am able to live the dream.
Okay.
And I would say, so get out of your fucking parents' basements, tech people. Start living the dream with me. Start by buying a paper copy, none of your Kindle bullshit, The Upgrade, a cautionary tale of life without respect.
And you're making it into a movie, are you?
I'm not. I have no qualifications in movie making. No, there is an option to make it into a movie has been bought. So there is a 0.001% possibility that at some point somebody will make a
And who's going to play you? Someone asked it.
I don't know.
Do you want to play you?
I don't know. No, I can't ask that because the... It was also less than an hour from Malaga Airport. More importantly, it was available until June for the off-season price of £420 a week. If Robert and I went halves on the rent, we'd be paying £210 a week. Again, I love that, explain that. Owning it in. Or £30 a night. Which included if we can clean your wife. EasyJet flights from London, it's just Google now. EasyJet flights from London. Well, less than £60 return, we could borrow a car for £10 a day. Even with transport, it was still under my £50 a night budget. The decision took me about 30 seconds to reach. But Robert's thinking hadn't stopped there. With an extra bedroom, he'd realised that we could offer weekend breaks to our friends for say, £200 for two nights, and cut our weekly rent in half at a stroke. I apologise to anyone who got that email. We won't.